For this lesson, you need to open the sample file World Sales 3 from your Sample Files folder. Up until now, you've selected a predefined chart style and color scheme from a gallery. Sometimes you may have a requirement that's not catered for within the selection of predefined styles offered by the Chart Styles gallery. In this case, you'll need to manually format one or more chart elements. Once you have the hang of formatting one element, it makes it easy to work with any other element, because the options are broadly the same. In this lesson, we'll manually format the chart title element. So I'll click on the chart title element to select it. Notice that when it's selected, a frame appears around the chart title element. Now I'll right-click the chart title element and select Format Chart Title from the shortcut menu. And the Format Chart Title task pane appears. Now this is a generic task pane that can be used to format any chart element. At the moment, you can see that it says Format Chart Title at the top. But let's click on one of the axes, and you can see that it's now changed to Format Axis. And if I click on the legend, you'll see that it changes to Format Legend. But I want to format the chart title element, so I'll click on the chart title element. And once again, the task pane says Format Chart Title. The first thing I'm going to do to the chart title element is to add a light blue background colour. So to do that, I'll first make sure I've clicked the Fill and Line icon, and then I'll click the Fill flyout menu. I want to fill with a solid colour, so I'll select Solid Fill. And now I want to select my colour, so I'll click the Fill Colour icon, and then select the lightest blue colour from the palette. Notice that there's also a transparency slider. As I slide this slider to the right, the colour washes out more and more until the cell will be completely white when I reach the right-hand side. I think I'll set a transparency of 80%. That will make the colour very light indeed. In fact, it will only just be visible. Now I'd like to set a border for the chart title element. To do that, once again, I'll make sure I've clicked the Fill and Line icon, and this time I'll click on the Border flyout menu. And you can see the options are to have no line, solid line, gradient line, or automatic. Well, I want a solid line, so I'll click Solid Line. I'd like my solid line to be black, so I'll click the Outline Color button and select Black. And I'd like it to be a little bit thicker. Instead of 0.75 points, I'd like it to be 1 point, so I'll use the Spin button to change the width of the line to 1 point. If I now click on one of the other elements, you can see that the formatting has been applied to the chart title element. Before ending this lesson, I'd like to demonstrate an ability of the chart title element that isn't well known amongst Excel users. That is its ability to contain a formula that references a worksheet cell. Let me demonstrate this. In cell E17, I'm going to type the text Sales Summary. And now I'm going to put a formula into the chart title element that will reference the text in cell E17 and display it within the chart title element. So I'll carefully hover the mouse cursor over the border of the chart title and double-click to select the chart title element. Now I'll click in the formula bar and press the equals key on the keyboard. And now I'll click once in cell E17 and then press the enter key on the keyboard. And you can see that the text sales summary now appears in the chart title element. But let's look more closely at that formula in the formula bar. You can see that it says equals sheet 1 exclamation mark and then the absolute reference E17. This is called a fully qualified cell reference, and it's required when you reference a cell from a chart title element. A simple reference, such as equals E17, won't work. You're going to learn more about fully qualified cell references later in Lesson 6.6. If the text now changes in cell E17, it will also change within the chart title element. But let's put things back to normal again now. I'll click on the chart title element, and instead of the formula, I'll enter the original text, sales first quarter. And I'll also delete the text from cell E17. All that remains now for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name, World Sales 4. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above, the Sample Files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 5.7, Manually Format a Chart Element.